I've been thinking a lot about how to wrap these tiny stones. So then I thought, you know, before I figure out how to wrap these stones, maybe I should figure out how to set this to put those stones around it. So, I've never really made a frame for a larger piece before, so this is, it's gonna be interesting. Should probably stress that this is not a tutorial because I don't know what I'm doing. And as a refresher, these are stones from a stone swap from a YouTuber. I think he pronounces his channel name Hallelujah. His name is Tyler. I'll put a link to his YouTube down below when I'm done. I sent him some fossils, and in my stone swap section, you can see him starting to wrap those. Now I need to get started on this. Really thick. I thought about trying to grind it, but then I thought, no, I'm gonna need to use this as it was sent to me. Yeah, I've never had a fire agate either, so this is an interesting stone. I'm trying to look through the sides to see how deep the fire part goes, and I'm unsure. I don't think it goes that deep, but I'm not willing to mess with this stone to see. So I think I'm going to have to build some kind of three-dimensional frame and then attach strings of these however I decide to set them, which also, he did a video and he was trying to show me how to do the bow tie setting, which I understand how to do it, but I'm not a big fan of it because I feel like it's not a strong setting. And in his heady settings, they work fine because they're tucked way in and they're snugged in and nothing's going to happen to them. But I'm not comfortable with it yet. Maybe I will be in the future. We'll see. But I was looking around YouTube for tutorial videos, which is a thing that I also don't do. And I came across a fairly new video that Raftarks did. And first try, I did it. So I think that I'm going to try this for some of those stones. And I'll put the link to the tutorial for Raftarks video, I hope I'm pronouncing his name right, underneath this. I probably won't be setting any of the little stones today. I'm just going to try and figure out how to make a frame. So I grabbed a piece of printer paper here to do another thing that I never do. Draw a picture of what I want to do. Or at least a general idea, and I probably should have gotten something to write with out before I sat down here, because no, I don't think Sharpie's a good idea in case I get it on the pen. Tell me I have a pencil. Of course I'm not going to have a pencil. Pen'll work. Jiggle, jiggle, jiggle. Now, let's see. Okay, so I need to do this again and again. I'll start up here. Just gonna trace around this. This doesn't really have to be perfect. I just need to really know how wide I need to. Oh, I have no idea what I'm doing. I wanna make strings. These are garnets. Thought there was another one here. Is that one? Yeah, I think so. Yeah, okay. Four garnets. So I think I want to make a row kind of out here like this. And then citrines are so small. Color do I want to go with next? Now he sent these colors because they all match the fire and the fire opal, or fire opal, fire agate. Right, there's a big citrine. There's a horse eye citrine, and there's a big citrine. Well, big-ish. Hmm. Oh my goodness, this is not the way I design. These
These are rubies, I think. Wait, what's that? Another one of those. Okay. Tiny. Tiny. Well, that one's even tiny. Tiny. Tiny, tiny. Itty bitty. Oh my goodness, these are so small. Dinky dinky. Something has to come over the edge here to cover this weird edge here. I don't think I want to use a setting to do that. I think I want to put a weave in there. So I'll bring these out. Oh, there's more garnets in there. That's good. Yeah. Because I want a row that's really long to kind of... Oh, that's another ruby. Is that a ruby? No, that's a garnet. These are different sizes. Okay, little. Big. Tiny's in there. Maybe we'll put these peridot down this side. There's a couple opals in here too, and I should try and get them in here somewhere. Squeak opal. Oval and two oval rounds. Maybe up this way. Rubies. Should get these rubies in here somewhere too. I feel like I should push this all out a little bit. Out. And put one, three rubies here. Okay. I love these citrines too. I'm not sure where to put those. Mainly what I want to do today is figure out how far out the frame needs to go from the stone. Otherwise I'll end up making it way too big. And I can always tuck these other stones in these other places. Okay, I think I have a general plan. Don't drop new stones in there. Okay, now. I'm gonna put these over here so I don't knock them around with the wire. Can't decide 16 or 18. 16 is definitely stronger. It's also going to be heavier. It's also super stiff to work with. And this 18 probably be stiff enough because I'll be attaching things to it. And that will shore it all up. And I also have this, I'm not even sure what gauge this square is. I've had it forever. You could tell because it's got the patina on it just from sitting around here. I have some square wire coming in the mail, but it's just not getting here quick enough. Watch, it's going to show up tomorrow. Because that's usually how it goes. This is really surprisingly soft. I'm going to go with the 18. I can always change my mind later. It's just wire. I've never made a frame before, but I'm having an idea of what I want to do, but I'm unsure if it's going to work, so this just might be an entire fail. So, cutters, pen get out of the way. Yo, I had a pen sitting right here the whole time. think I might want, so I want to have places where I can attach the ends of these. I think I want to go something like that. So I think to do that, I'm going to go and attach wires like this, and this will be a separate wire. That's a separate wire. Then I'll attach them all here to each other. And then I can bend them and the angle down to make it a three-dimensional setting. I guess I can always attach extra wires in the middle if I need more anchor points. But how do I attach? Oh, yeah, I could do like that. I don't know. I didn't know what to do with the ends of those wires. So I could bring them right back up the middle, I guess. Ends down and up the middle. This is just getting way complicated. All right. Okay, well, I guess let me just try it and see, and that's what we need to do. Don't need gigantic pieces of wire. Let's see a piece in there. Okay, let's see. Wires. Something like this. Probably do something straight across the back too. So maybe I'll take these straight across the back. Bring the tails in. How can they meet in a not crazy way? Take these tails straight up for a bail. So I have to make a turn here, make a turn here, make a turn there, to come. So I'll end up with six wires straight up the middle. A lot of wires. A lot of 18 gauge wires. I don't have to use them all, they can get cut and tucked. Oh, then these will have to be way much longer if I'm gonna do that. I don't know what I'm doing. Already made a mistake. Cutting wire is way too short. Right, so one point here. And I kind of want to put it just under this edge. Because then I'll come back with something decorative to cover that edge. I cut another wire because I cut this one? No, because I don't really want this one that long. Okay, now let's just do this. Make this next one longer. Not that. Still not that. I think what I'm gonna do is just bend this. Now I want to attach these two together a little bit. Oh, this is gonna become a nightmare, isn't it? So, what do I attach them together with? I think. Is this the right one? Yeah, I'm gonna use, this is 21 gauge half round. And that giant black spool that everyone knows.
Harvey the cat, did you want to say hi? Oi, there's Harvey the cat. I'm not going to flip her over to look at the screen. She wants to sit on my lap now. Geez, we're already 15 minutes in. Everyone bored yet? I'm going to take the tail of this around that inside wire just so this wire doesn't slide up and down. See there? Already slid up and now I've locked it down wrong. Where is the end? Okay, there we go. Now that it's anchored down. This might be all the longer. No, I think it needs to go longer because it has to go 3D down. Okay, no, stop sliding wire. It's enough of that nonsense. I think it's going to be it. Bend these out a little bit so they don't slide up and down all crazy. Cut this off. Use that on the next strap. Tuck all these little tails down because I know I'll jab myself with them. Now. This one down. So right. Just around that point. Maybe it should be at the point. Right here, I think. Like so. And I'm just gonna bend that. And attach it there. This is just a riveting video to watch. Just me muddling through. Wires just don't want to lay still. Keep still, wires. Keep still.
just jumping all around back there. Okay. That. Is that long enough? Is that long enough? I'm starting to question everything now. I have no choice but to be long enough. Let's just make this one just a little longer. Bend down a little. Okay. All right. I think that's what I want. I'm probably making this a lot more difficult than it needs to be. Now, where do we want to go over here? Around. Yeah, we'll go up that rough edge. I think. I want another anchor point. Out there. Bend this. Please for this. This side needs to be a lot longer. This is a side where I really want to focus on the stones. Consider it, you might not even be able to see what I'm doing. Sorry, guys. Everyone is starting to twist on me. My way. Oops, I've Now. Getting to the end here. Piece to fit right in there. Okay. Another piece of 18 gauge. Bend that again so I can attach it there. Cut that off, don't I? Cut that off. And that little tail can go. Sorry, bump the camera. I think the light over here is causing a problem. Better or worse? Don't get it. Making shadows. Tail around there again. Oops. Somehow I just turned it half around the wrong way around. Same length as that other side. A little longer, I think. All right, I think that's it. Okay, now need to make the last piece fit the way I want it to. Like so. Don't have enough hand. Okay. sitting there like that. Is this making sense to anybody else? It's kind of making sense to me. An idea in my head. See how well it translates. Okay. Is this going to be enough? I guess we'll see. In and this is it? Is all the further I've gotten? Too much talking. Is this gonna be long enough? I do not want to add another little piece. That's about as long as that other one, yeah. Up a little. Add another one there. This light is bad. Is that better? Ooh, no, this light is better. This is the light I use to film episodes and stuff. Uh-oh, scratchy little tails, you gotta go. Now. Now I can't remember how I had it this way. Okay. Phew. Push this in. Just like so. I think this looks like progress. I want these to all angle down. To give a gentle slope out from the thickness of the stone. Oh, there's tail in this. Up and then down. I'm just gonna lean it up so I can just see. Okay. Progress. Let's move that out of the way. And we want to take all of these. This way and that way. I'll put my background. Take that out for now. Each to their sides. And to the side. To the side. Thinking. of space I'm going to have to fill. That's the idea, put all those little stones in that space. Back. I think I want to wrap those just to keep them snug. They aren't all dancing around all over the place. The wires like to do. Bend them out a little so I can do that. Hopefully, none of this that you're seeing, that I'm doing right now, is going to be seen on the front when the piece is all done. Which is going to be adding a lot more elements than I've ever added to anything. Now I'm wrapping this around upside down. But we're just going to keep going because that's where I'm at right now. Looks weird wrapping it upside down. Oh, sorry guys. Bump the camera. Sure how long I want this. So, it's kind of that tight, so what I'm going to do is cut this tail off, and I will come back to the back and work that out later once I have this frame all secured in the front. A little tail to get rid of. Did I just bend that wire in there? Trying to... Is it this way? Let's bend this way. No, this way. No, everything's okay. Okay. That's the way it was supposed to be bent, because that's the shape of the stone. Whew! Panicked myself. This wire come across and hold that in from the back. Yep. That's a plan. What if I do it right now? Too soon, do you think? Live on the edge? I don't know. I'm more accustomed to working with the stones sitting in place. Well, something's happening here. I'm not sure if it's good or not. But it's definitely something. Okay. Let's do this the right way now. Chance it'll fall out the front, but it's an agate, and agates are pretty sturdy. They tolerate me. And most of my designs that I make, I like to start with the exact length of base wire that I'm going to use in the whole thing. So most of my pieces are continuous base wires. You know, if you've watched my videos, you've probably noticed. Because I've always been averse to adding pieces to it. I don't know why. It's just something I've never done. So this adding elements is something entirely new to me. People are doing it all the time, so it's gotta work, right? So people are making great things just adding pieces and adding pieces, and here I am probably stifling my own creative ideas just by wanting to use continuous base wires. So stretch is what this whole thing is for. Try new things. And I wish Alleluia would have tried a coiled bezel. Don't know if he's ever done it before, but I sent him the stones that he could have done it. Alright, now what do we have going on back here that I didn't even look at? This one around here. And it's gotta go down there, right? Yeah. We should have cut that tail off before I secured it down. We are making progress. 45 minutes in. Think I can finish this frame in the next 15 minutes? I'm going to cut these short tails. They're just flying everywhere. That long tail? Yeah, I'm gonna leave that there for now. Two. These two. As far as I know, I could be making some fundamental mistake. The heady rappers are all cringing. They're like, no, what are you doing? Stop that! Whoop, yep, there it goes. Oh no! It's big enough not to get lost on my floor. Okay, we'll just leave that out for now. And come back to this. Need some more half round. I think this tiny half round, I'm going to try and set some of those stones with it. Like I said, Raftar got a new tutorial. Well, it looked new to me. I don't know. Still figuring out how this YouTube thing works, but it was close to the front of this tutorial, so I'll put the link in the bottom. And I might have to look for, or I might have to actually use the bow tie setting for some of the stones, because some of them have really unique shapes. Just seems like a lot of wire. It's going to be a really heavy thing when it's done. Yeah, Stone, I'm about to beat you up trying to work this out. That way, yeah. I really want this up a little closer to this edge. It's not gonna happen since I already lashed it down. Alright, that's where it's gotta go. Okay. Stop being distracted by other things and get this done. Nobody wants to watch an hour long video of you muddling through stuff. Let's see, where haven't we lashed one down? Over here. Around this guy. This one doesn't have a home or homeless wire. like it should go up here, but that one already has one. All right, put another one there. Don't really want to, but you gotta go somewhere. Free over here. 8 minutes to an hour. Should have made these wires a little longer. This is how we learn. Just do it. Until around there. Like so. And it's back and see where it goes. I think that I'm just gonna put these around this wire that's right there, but I want to cut them shorter so I don't have to fight with a wire that long. Just want to hook them around there. They have to be flat so they don't push the stone out. Down point a bit. Get down. Ta-da. Is that a tail I decided not to cut off? I have no idea what I'm going to do about a bale for this. Okay, one more. There. There, okay. I need that. I don't understand why people solder frames. Probably a lot quicker. 55 minutes, 39 seconds. And under. these. I think of this one. This one are going to be friends right there for a while. And this one. It's going to go around there. With any luck, I'm going to do a weave that's going to cover some of this back. Not all of it, though, because I want the light to be able to shine through the faceted stones. So, we'll see. Alright. There's my frame, ready for anybody to yell at me about it. It is way down this stone further than I want it to be. Places to attach all the rows of gemstones and some extra decorative leaves. What do we think? Is that okay for our very first try at a frame? Guess we'll find out as we go. Thanks for hanging in there with me.